During my second senior year when Mom found Jesus Christ, his spirit was trapped inside an old Manischewitz bottle that Mom picked out of the dumpster behind the 7-Eleven. Mom brought the bottle inside and set it down on top of the TV. Then she told all of us kids to gather around, and then she explained how Jesus lived in the bottle, and how if she wanted to, she could call him out to do her bidding. Sis said it reminded her of an old TV show, and Mom slapped her and called her a heretic. I didn't say anything, because I can still remember that time outside the Safeway, when I took four security guards to hold Mom down.
Jesus loves me, yes I know, for the Bible tells me so. When I'm weak, he makes me strong, that's why I sing this song. If I die before I wake, pray to him my soul. Jesus loves me, yes I know.
It wasn't long before people from all over the world started coming to our house to see the bottle. At first I thought that this would make me more popular at school, but instead it seemed to have the opposite result. Kids would stop in the halls and point at me and say, there's the boy whose mother keeps our savior cooped up in that tiny little bottle. And then everybody started calling me Bottle Boy, and that really hurt. It was also around this time that Mom began to attract some pretty weird followers, like that guy who never used deodorant and spoke only in riddles, and that woman who collected 19th century handmade Amish swimwear.
Jesus loves me, yes I know, for the Bible tells me so. If I die before I wake, pray to him my soul. Okay, Jesus loves me, yes I know.
Mommy, she loved Jesus, but not like others did, for she had a special bottle in which our Savior lived. Mommy, she loved Jesus, but not like others did, for she could unleash his vengeance by unfastening the lid. As the year went on, things went from bad to worse, and I realized if it wasn't a big change pretty soon, I'd never be able to get a date for the prom. I couldn't go the year before because Mom belonged to a church and considered dancing a one-way ticket to hell. But that's a whole other story. Anyway, by this point, Mom had appeared on The Richard Bay Show, AM Philadelphia, and Geraldo. So there was no use in me changing schools since everybody knew who my mom was. Also, we had to spend all the money for Mom's personal appearances to hire a bodyguard, since by this point, we were getting about 400 death threats a day.
Jesus loves me, yes I know, for the Bible tells me so. When I'm weak, he makes me strong, that's why I sing this song. If I die before I wake, pray to him my soul. Okay, Jesus loves me, yes I know.
Then, one night, I just couldn't stand it anymore. While everyone else was sleeping, I crept downstairs. Slowly, I went up to the bottle and began to unfasten the lid. At first, nothing happened, but then the room filled with a thick, white smoke. I was glad my sister had taken the batteries out of the smoke detector to put near a Walkman. When the smoke cleared, I found myself face to face with the Son of God, who was much shorter than I had expected. He told me that since I freed him, he'd grant me one wish, and that's how I got to go to the prom with Gina Davis. But you've probably already read about that in People.
Jesus loves me, yes I know, for the Bible tells me so. When I'm weak, he makes me strong, that's why I sing this song. If I die before I wake, pray to him my soul will be. Jesus loves me, yes I know.
Mommy, she loved Jesus, but not like others did, for she has a special bottle in which our Savior lived. Mommy, she loved Jesus, but not like others did, for she could unleash his vengeance by unfastening the lid. Mommy, she loved Jesus, but not like others did, for she had a special bottle in which our Savior lived. Mommy, she loved Jesus, but not like others did, for she could unleash his vengeance by unfastening the lid.